Let us all be standing for God's worship. The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right path for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Amen. Sweet, sweet spirit. It's a sweet, sweet spirit in this place.
It's a sweet, sweet spirit in this place.
Be glorified, be praised. Hallelujah to your name. You're worthy, you're worthy, you're worthy. And Lord, we just want to give you praise for what you have done for us, dear God, on Calvary's cross. How, Lord, you have taken us up, dear God, from the miry clay. And Lord, Father, you have washed us. You have cleansed us. You have made us into your own vessels, dear God, that you can use us. Oh, hallelujah to your name. You're worthy, God. We are, dear God, your own. Our body is your temple. Oh, God, receive the glory today. Receive the praise as we adore you. And Lord, as we call upon you. Lord, we thank you, dear God, that today you have given us, dear Lord, this opportunity to come in your presence. An opportunity, dear God, that we did not have yesterday. Because, dear God, your mercies are new evermore. And today, dear God, we can, through your help, dear God, we can do better. We can do more. We can please you, dear God. And Lord, we thank you for this opportunity. Lord, I pray, dear God, that as we worship you today, that Lord, you will have your, you will have, dear God, the preeminence in and over our lives. That our Lord, in all things, you will be praised. We want to join the angels, dear God, around your throne. Singing, worthy, worthy is the Lamb. Singing, holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. The earth is filled with your glory. And indeed, dear God, it is filled with your glory. Lord, thank you that you have given unto us life, physically and spiritually. And we praise you for it, Lord. Lord, today, dear God, we want to look in our midst. And Father, we want to ask of you, dear Lord, to comfort, dear God, to be bereaved, dear Lord. Once more, dear God, the Johnsons, dear God. Lord, the children mourn the death of their mom. Especially Sister Claudia, dear God, Father, comfort her. Comfort the family, dear God. Because it's another that they have lost in just a few months. Father, remember Sister Pansy. Lord, just comfort her, dear God, as she has lost her life partner. And Father, remember Sister Lance's father. Lord, you are our comforter. You are the one, dear God, who walk alongside us. You are the one, dear God, who lead and guide us. Father, have your own way. Today, dear God, anoint afresh your manservant, even as he comes with your word. Lord, let your words go forth mightily and accomplish what it will. Through Jesus Christ, the Lord and our Savior. Amen. Amen. At this time, praise and worship team will come as we continue to give God the praise and to give him the glory. He's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah.
God is good. God is good.
God is good to me.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Great are you, Lord. Yes. Greatly to be praised. There is none. There is none like our God. There is none to be compared to David. Because there is no other God. All our idols.
Amen.
There is only one God. And we give God our adoration and our praise.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Praise God. Thank you, praise team. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Our preacher for today has many names. Theophilus T. Great fisherman. They call him sometimes evangelist too, because of his run elsewhere. Also, the man is called Jacob. But what's the name, huh? Identity. Because most of all, he's called a Christian, a child of God, a proclaimer of the truth of Almighty God. And so at this time, just want to welcome our dear pastor, Pastor Winston Jackson here at the Penwood Church of Christ. Our senior pastor, and he will be delivering the word of Almighty God momentarily. So let us all be standing at this time.
So she had just stopped eating and she wanted to be with her Lord. And she is with her Lord. Praise God. Praise God. Right old age. Praise the Lord. I will be continuing and completing a sermon series. Remember I said continuing and completing. So that means that today is going to be the final sermon in this series. I am reminded that this series started in June. Can you believe it? And the first sermon I preached in this series was When You Are Depressed. You remember that one? And it was in June, way back in June, the 7th of June. And we are now in September. We're just wrapping it up after having gone through a number of others. You know, when you need a financial breakthrough, you know, when your faith is fading, you remember those, you remember when your praise is shaking? Remember that one? Remember the one that was preached last week? When your life really matters. All right. So we're going to be concluding that series today. Join in a word of prayer. Father, we give you thanks, Lord, that you have led us this far. To this point, Lord God, where we are able to say, praise your name because of your faithfulness. Almighty God, we come before you, Lord, with open hearts. Fill us, Lord God, from your word. Fill me, O Holy Spirit, and let me, Lord God, be a vessel used to pour your word into the hearts and lives of your people. Bless your word, Lord God, and let it be, Lord, a word for the moment. In Christ's name, amen. Remember that all of these messages have something to do with what is happening in our current experience here during this pandemic. This pandemic, COVID-19, has a downside. And some people say many downsides. It has a downside. And I want to think that the downside to this pandemic is that it has wreaked havoc with our normal, everyday life. Life is not the same anymore. Our way of life has been totally altered. And this has happened in just a few short months. Yes? Because if I can recall, it was in March that things started to happen in Georgia. And that's a few short months. And within that time, life as we knew it then has been changed, has been altered. People are becoming frustrated. People are becoming depressed, hopeless, defeated even. People are becoming bored. There are a number of students that like, are bored. And some people are becoming reckless. One of the things that we have heard about, you know, just what has been happening during this time is that there has been an increase in the cases of domestic abuse. Yeah, spousal abuse. You know, there has been an increase in the cases of child abuse as the children are now at home and are becoming more vulnerable to these attacks, as I would call them. Right? These have become more prevalent during the pandemic. And what I think is happening is that the hardships and the social deprivation that this pandemic has caused has made people desperate. Yeah? They are finding release in acts of abuse and sometimes even suicide. They are finding some release from what is happening. They believe that this is a way to get so for argument's sake, they are taking it out on the children. Whatever is happening to them, if they lost their jobs, they're taking it out on the family. Yes? Right? So if they are faced with serious crises in terms of, you know, getting their children educated, whatever, they take it out on the family. It's a kind of a release that is happening. A sick release, even. But it seems to me, and I am not really a clinical psychologist, but it seems to me that this could very well be a part of what is happening in the society. People are dying for this chapter of history to be closed. The only for it to be closed is even. People are dying for it to be closed. And while it is going on, people are dying well. Yeah.
They have had enough. They have had enough of mask wearing. They have had enough of social distancing, quarantine, sanitizing of hands regularly. They have had enough of disinfecting their clothes and shoes when they reach home. They have just had enough. Enough of everything. Enough, enough, enough. They have had their fill of online education, some of our students. They're tired of it. They're dying to go back to school, right? They have had their fill of that. Some of them have not even had any of it. We have had our fill of online church services. And being like this in our services, yeah? The older generation, they have had their fill. I know mamas had their fill of staying home and staring at the four walls. Yes, they have had their fill of that. They have had their fill of non-attendance at funeral services. They are not able to breathe properly and to have closure. Yeah, they have had their fill of that. The inability to visit the elderly in nursing homes. Yeah. They have had our fill. They're filled up that, right? Not being able to visit their family members who are older. Enough is enough, many people are saying. But brethren, this COVID pandemic has an upside. I just told you some of the downside. But it has an upside. And the upside is that it has come to make us have a greater sense of appreciation for the things that we used to take for granted. Especially us, the people of God. There are so many things that we used to take for granted. Now we begin to appreciate it so much more. Praise God. You never know the use of the water until the well runs dry. So we know the use of water. You never know the use of water until National Water Commission lock off your water. And then you begin to appreciate the need for water. Because before that, you used to leave the pipe dripping. Yes? Uh-huh. You never used to fix things readily as soon as you see the toilet tank running. You just leave it. But when water is gone, that's the time when you understand the importance and the value of water. Mm-hmm. True? Mm-hmm. COVID-19 has come to slow down the fast lane people. People like to live in the fast lane. People are just go, go, go. COVID has come to slow us down. Remember, I'm telling you about upsides now. It has come to slow us down. It has come to alter and to change our instant gratification mindset. Want it? No. No. COVID has come to change all of that. It has given us time to ponder. Time to reflect, time to assess, and time to reconfigure our thoughts about life and our priorities. That's what it has come to do. And if you haven't been doing this, you haven't learned the lessons. You have not learned the lessons that this is giving. As children of God, everything that happens and confronts us in this life provides an opportunity for spiritual growth and character development. Say it again. Everything that happens in our existence, our experiences, our circumstances, everything that happens does not happen by accident. It doesn't happen by chance. It happens by design if you're a child of God. And the design is this, it must make you learn, grow, and develop. And not just grow physically, but grow in spirit.
Amen.
Grow in love. Grow in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. COVID is providing us with that opportunity in this time, in this moment. I want to encourage all of us, those of us who have had enough of COVID-19, those who are tired of this pandemic, I want to encourage you to learn an important lesson and to use the period of COVID-19, if you have not been doing so, to develop these twin character traits. They walk hand in hand. Patience and perseverance. So I want to talk to you about when you have had enough. When you have had enough. What are the twin character traits I told you about that you must cultivate during this time? Patience and perseverance. Slightly different, but they complement each other. In some cases, perseverance and patience are used synonymous. Right? They mean the same thing. Patience and perseverance, I want to begin by saying this, is a must for God's people. We must have it. There is no other option that we have as long as we are kingdom people. We must cultivate patience. We must have perseverance. They will love to talk about the race not being funny. Swift. Yeah. But for those who endure. Patience and persevere, those who persevere. It is a fruit that God's people must cultivate in increasing measure. Let's look at 2 Peter 1. And look at verse 3. We're going down from verse 3 to about 9. It says, His divine power has given us everything we need for a godly life through our knowledge of Him, who called us by His own glory and goodness. Through these, He has given us His very great and precious promises, so that through them you may participate in the divine nature, having escaped the corruption in the world caused by evil desires. For this very reason, make every effort to add to your faith goodness, and to goodness, knowledge. And to knowledge, self-control. And to self-control, perseverance. And to perseverance, godliness. And to godliness, mutual affection or brotherly love. And to mutual affection, love. For if you possess these qualities in increasing measure, they will keep you from being ineffective and unproductive in your knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. But whosoever does not have them is nearsighted and blind, forgetting that they have been cleansed from their past sins. Do you see why it is important for us to have perseverance? The Word of God tells us that if we don't have it, we are being forgetful people. We will always forget that we have been cleansed from our past sins. You check the nation of Israel and you will realize that it's the same thing with the nation of Israel. That's what happened to them. That's how they messed up. They weren't persevering people. They wanted the quick fix. As they came out of Egypt, they wanted Egypt's food. Yeah. As they came out of Egypt, they wanted Egypt cemetery. Uh-huh. So it is important, God's people, that we cultivate this fruit in our life. The fruit of patience, perseverance, As a matter of fact, it is a spiritual fruit, and it's mentioned in that fruit of the Spirit that we have in Galatians 5, 22 and 23. Let's just look at that and show you that patience is there, right? Fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness and self-control. You know where patience falls? Forbearance. Long-suffering. Some of our Bibles say persevering. Perseverance is a fruit of God's Spirit. Our world has embraced the instant gratification mentality. We have learned it from where our growing up society teaches us that. We need to grow up fast, sometimes, and foolish. I remember that there was this viral video just went around the place of this little innocent child that adults are teaching that child to smoke and to drink. As a society we live in, this is not outside a particular norm. Just because this one was captured on video. But I know, long, long time ago, when I was growing up, that it was a popular pastime of adult parents, to drunk their children, give them beer, alcohol, give them and laugh when they see them reeling and. What a sick society. What a sick, depraved society. But even that little child is being taught things that that child has no control over. It is a sick parent, a sick mother, and sick adults that are bringing this child into something that this child has no place in, or that has no place in this child's life. We want it now, so we indulge in things like fast food. We love fast food. There are some people who don't eat nothing more than fast food. I want it now. Can't sit down and watch a bad food. Have to walk now. Sometimes if you walk through some places, some societies, they can't tell you the last time they had a open meal. Fast food, speed dating, you know that? Do you know about it? Huh? Speed dating. We crave 5G speeds. Some of us are dying for 5G to come to Jamaica. Yeah. That's the kind of speed that we want. We want it now. We want it to happen as we go. So bam, exactly. Everything must be at our fingertips. Because of the way that we have been cultured, because of the way that society, I want to say, broke us bad, it is imperative for the child of God to use every opportunity to learn and to exercise patience. Learn to wait in a line patiently. Ella was telling me yesterday that, was it yesterday, the day before yesterday, he was in a bank. They were at number 16. His number was 88. What did he have to do? Wait. And wait patiently. I am sure that Elder Walker has cultivated a measure of patience from that wait. True, Elder? Learn to wait in a line. We have a problem with lines, eh? Don't like lines. The only line that people like to wait in is the locker line. And even that is breaking down right now. Learn to live in the slow lane sometimes. It's better for your physical and your spiritual health. Mm-hmm. Slow down. Slow down. The passage in 2 Peter 1 that we just read tells us that when we possess perseverance among the other spiritual qualities that are there, when we possess it, we will become effective and productive in our knowledge of Christ. Slow down. Smell the roses. Watch a sunset. Yeah, do a little fishing. Teach your patience. Always tell people that when I go out, I do fishing, I don't do catching. Catching is what God does for me. Read a book. When's the last time you read a book? Read a book. Slows you down. Do some crochet work if you are able to. Macrame, not craft. Do something like that. Make something. Yeah. Pray for an hour. Too challenging. COVID has given you that opportunity. Pray for an hour. Watch something grow. Never observe things growing. Just watch something grow. You won't see why it is growing, but you'll certainly see growing. These things will help you to grow in your patience. COVID-19 has blessed you with the opportunity to enjoy life in the slow lane. Enjoy life in the slow lane, thus learning patience. Praise God. But you know something about patience and perseverance, Zakali? We develop patience and perseverance in pressure situations. That's how we develop it. You don't develop patience when everything is good and okay. No, when everything is all right, you do not learn perseverance and patience. It is pressure that causes you to learn patience and perseverance. And what is more pressuring right now than COVID-19? 2 Thessalonians 1, 3 and 4. Let's look at what it says. We ought always to thank God for you, brothers and sisters, and rightly so, because your faith is growing more and more, and the love all of you have for one another is increasing. Therefore, among God's churches, we boast about your perseverance and faith in all the persecutions and trials you are enduring. You hear that? Paul wrote to those Christians, the Thessalonians. He wrote to them telling them that, listen, your perseverance during a time of persecution and trial is something that we boast about. It is a time of persecution and trial that brings the best out of our perseverance and our ability to be patient. So when you ask God to allow you to be more patient, expect trials. Because the only way that patience and perseverance is going to be produced in the child of God is through triumph. It's through challenge. This is what Paul told the saints at Rome. Romans 5, 3 to 5. This is what he said. Not only so, but we also glory in our sufferings, because we know that suffering, complete that. Suffering produces what? And perseverance does what? Produce what? Character. And character produces hope. Continue. And hope does not put us to shame, because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. Are you surprised that suffering produces perseverance? I am not. Because what we call it, sufferation is what is going to produce perseverance in God's people. Nothing else. God is not just going to dump perseverance on you. No. It is sufferation that causes patience and perseverance. Amen? Look again in Romans 12:12. Joyfully move. Patient in what? In affliction. Affliction is going to bring out patience. Faithful in prayer. You see, it is fire, Christian. Fire that burns out the impurities in gold. It's fire. Gold tried by fire. Not water. Not syrup. Fire. And so sometimes we love the sweet things. Yeah? We love the sweet life. I tell you something. It is hardship that produces in you the character that God requires.
Yes.
And that's why you ever wonder sometimes, oh yeah, it's so hard. Praise God. Rejoice, the word of God says. Rejoice in tribulation. Because tribulation works or produces patience. Rejoice in it. But boy, I tell you the truth. We have turned the scriptures totally upside down. In tribulations, we don't rejoice. We bow. We complain. We make noise. Eh? Some of us even want to curse God when tribulation faces us. Turning the scripture totally on its head. When the word of God is telling us, when hard times take you, rejoice. Rejoice. Because you are going to learn a character trait, a quality that God wants and desires and requires of his people. Don't learn it. You're not God's child. Not God's child. Oh boy. God doesn't hate us when he sends these trials upon us. When he gives us these troublesome situations. He doesn't hate us. The enemy hates us. And the enemy hopes that these trials and tribulations, that they will cause us to lose hope. It will bend and warp our faith in God. That's what he hopes. That it will twist us out of shape spiritually. God is smiling when he brings them upon his people. God is smiling. Because God says, I can turn it around. I can turn it to my children's benefit. So give it your best shot, my child.
the bounce back. Just like Job, he will bounce back. And he did bounce back. Hallelujah.
So it doesn't matter how hard the thing looks. One man says, if God leads you to it, he will take you through it. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So it is fire that burns out our impurities. Instead of throwing up our hands in the air, saying that I have had enough, can we look at the hidden blessing behind COVID-19? Eh? Can we look at the blessing of cultivating patience and perseverance that it provides?
Amen.
Instead of throwing up our hands in the air and saying, Lord, me done. Why not throw up your hands in the air and say, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. It is a blessing. It is a blessing. James has this to say in James 5, 10 and 11. Brothers and sisters, as an example of patience in the face of suffering, take the prophets who spoke in the name of the Lord. They are our example. As you know, we count as blessed those who have persevered. You have heard of Job's perseverance, and I just spoke about it. And you have seen what the Lord finally brought about. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. Can you agree with that?
Amen.
Full of compassion and mercy. He will never leave us alone in our tribulation. Never. Never do. Only trust. How many of us can say, truly say, that this pandemic has produced joy in us? How many of us can say that? That the persecutions and the tribulations associated with this pandemic has brought forth joy in us? See, many of us, our joy has leaked out. Uh-huh. And our joy has been replaced by complaining, by sorrow, by despair, and even by depression. But this, however, should not be the mindset of God's people. That's not how we should be. When we do that, we fail God. We fail God. James 1, verse 2 and 4. 2 to 4. Let me read that. James 1, 2 to 4. And let me read it. You read it. What it says. So you hear what James is saying? Consider it. Go back to the first verse. Consider it pure joy. As we said, pure joy you must have when you face trials of many kinds. Are we facing trials of many kinds now?
Yes.
So therefore, joy should be produced in the child of God. And the reason why we should be joyful is that we know that these trials won't upend us. They won't destroy us. These trials are working perseverance in our lives. Amen? Amen. Amen. In times like these, we need to let God's Spirit have full reign in us. Full reign! So that we can begin to experience the growth. The growth spark even that God has planned for us through this trial called COVID-19. A growth spark that God wants to achieve in his people. Too many of God's people have gone on this downward spiral. Yeah? Spiritually. We have spiraled downward spiritually. And I beseech you in the name of Jesus Christ to persevere under this current hardship. Persevere. Because as James says, perseverance must finish its work. It must finish its work. So that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything. Hallelujah. When your perseverance is finished, when it has reached its end, its optimal state, you will be mature in Christ. You will be complete in Christ. You won't lack for anything spiritual in Christ. Hallelujah. Praise God. So I want to close. I'm close by saying this. That the word of God compares us to grass. I spoke about this some time ago. You know that the word of God says all flesh is grass, don't it? You know that? Do we know that? Alright. And I'm saying, if we are grass, we must cultivate the quality of grass. Yeah. If you are grass, you must cultivate the quality of grass. I tell you what the quality of grass is. You see when drought comes? When hard time fears grass? Sun, drought, whatever. The grass is scorched. True. You look up on the hills, you see the hills look brown. Sometimes the grass even disappears. You don't see the grass. But watch when the rain starts to fall. Just watch when the rain starts to fall. Where you saw beer, grass begins to spring back there. And nobody planted any grass there. The grass was waiting patiently for the rains to come. Can we take unto ourselves that quality? Wait until the rains come. COVID is not going to be here forever. No? No matter what you hear anybody say, it too shall pass. But what condition will it find us in after it has passed? Are we able to spring up back like grass? Flourish again? Or will we be kept down there? Dead, dying, scorched, and not benefiting from the healing rain that God sends to his people? Some of us would have grown and matured in our faith, in our perseverance, and in our Christian walk. I ask you this question. Would this passage of scripture that I am about to read, would it have been manifested in your life? Ecclesiastes 7 and verse 8. The end of a matter is better than its beginning, and patience is better than pride. Would you have manifested this truth? It's a scriptural truth, it's a divine truth. Would you have manifested it at the end of COVID to show to others that the end of this matter is better than the beginning? I have come off better as a child of God at the end of COVID than I was at the beginning of it. Think about that. Think about that. There's an encouragement given to God's people by the writer to the Hebrews. In Hebrews 10, verse 32 to 36, he says, remember those earlier days after you had received the light, when you endured in a great conflict full of suffering. Sometimes you were publicly, and it was talking to the Hebrews, and it says there, sometimes you were publicly exposed to insult and persecution. At other times you stood side by side with those who were so treated. You suffered along with those in prison and joyfully accepted the confiscation of your property, because you knew that you yourself had better and lasting possessions. So do not throw away your confidence. It will be richly rewarded. You need to persevere so that when you have done the will of God, you will receive what He has promised. Hallelujah. So brethren, may God bless you as you use this COVID-19 pandemic time. Throw your hands up in victory and not in defeat. As you use this trial to let your head be lifted up in praise and adoration to Almighty God, and not to let it hang down in despair. Press along, saints. Press along. In God's own way, persecution we must bear, trials and crosses in our way. Hotter the battle, sweeter the victory. Don't just sing it, live it. God bless you.
When you have had enough, be patient, persevere. Are we willing to persevere? Are we willing to just throw up our hands and give up our faith? I pray that we stand. And having done all, we stand. We stand. And expect the full reward from Almighty. Let us all be standing at this time. You're my strength, and I am indeed God is. And I pray that we rely upon Him in all.
You are my strength when I am weak. You are the treasure that I see. You are my all in all. Thank you.
Thank you, Pastor Jack. You may be seated. We look to the Lord as we seek to remember His death on the cross for our sins. At this time, for the Clifton, the Carter Reverend, we will come with our meditation.
In the book of Colossians, Paul speaking to the Colossian church. It is short of a question. He made a bold statement. If he then be risen with Christ, see those things which are above, where Christ sitteth at the right hand of God. Set your affections on the things above, not on the things of the earth. Every time I would want to contemplate why Paul didn't stop there and just ask the question so that one could reflect. COVID-19 is very, very horrible. It's something that takes us out of the norm. At home, for me personally, I've been in some religious talk with a little 6-year-old. He has been throwing a lot of blows. I have been doing well. Then one day he asked a very powerful question at me sitting down. He said, "Daddy, are you still practicing Christianity?" And I said, "Why not?" He said that, "I don't see reading your Bible, I don't see you praying." And just before I go to answer, then he said to me, "But Daddy, God is not good. He is dying." And I was again going to answer, then I next blow. And then I realized that COVID-19 is a sobering time for a Christian. It gives us an opportunity to check our desires. So yesterday, and next thing happened. So he said, "Last week you said that you never had a car, couldn't come to church, but I would have gone to school. Why is it that I cannot come to church?" And then I gave you. You know what it does for us? It's a desired thing. You know, sometimes as Christians, during this COVID-19 time, we desire a lot of things. We desire a break, we desire a chance to go to the beach. We desire an opportunity for us to just to go to play some dominoes. For me personally, I want to play some dominoes and relieve the stress. But it should be a time for us to reflect as Christians, to look on the perspective from God's vantage point, that this world is a world that is filled with a lot of troubles. This world is not a world for a Christian to rest and to be comfortable, but this world is a, we would say in drama, that it's a rehearsal for the things to come. So for Christians, you have to be sober-minded, that we don't long for this world, but we long for a better place. Amen. We long for the coming of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So this presents an opportunity for us to check ourselves, to check our temperature, to find out if we truly desire the things of the Lord. And let us not fool ourselves that we as children of God, we have hope. We have our hope, and our hope is in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. For those who are perishing, they don't know. But we really and truly know that if our hope was really in this world, we would have been men who need much pity. So Christians, let us be sober. Let us be sober-minded and ensure that we don't get caught up in all this excitement with COVID-19, but to be consumed by our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Because there is coming a day when all of us will be judged for what we would have done with our time and with our resources. So let us ensure that we are wrapped up and tied up in Jesus, because in Him alone there is only true hope. Let us pray. Most righteous and heavenly Father God, we thank you, Lord God, that even before now, Lord God, you, Lord, would have sent your Son to die for us, Lord God. You would have been the comforter with us, Lord God, to give us comfort, Lord God. Although worlds may fall around us, Lord God, we stand resolute in you, Lord, because you are our hope, Lord God, and you are our future, Lord God. Whatever may beset us here, Lord God, we know, Lord God, that there is a better future for us, Lord God. That when that day you would have made your return, Lord God, we will be ready, Lord. And we know, Lord God, that we will mourn no more, Lord, but we will be happy, Lord. Lord, bless the men who serve at your table, Lord God. And for all those who partake of the communion, Lord God, that they will partake knowing that, Lord, that in you, Lord God, there is body of joy. In your precious and holy name, I pray. Amen. Lord, we are still happy, Lord God, that you sent your only begotten Son, Lord, to die on the cross for us, Lord God. We are even more happy, Lord God, that your blood still washes, Lord God, that it still holds the healing power, Lord God. Lord, as we continue to journey in you, Lord God, we pray, Lord God, that you will continue, Lord God, to build a fence around us, Lord God. Even though this world may come around us, Lord God, we stand resolute, Lord God, and know that in you, Lord, we have all our hope. In your precious and holy name, I pray. Amen.
Truly, we want to say thank God for today and just want to praise His name. Quickly, some announcements. We want to once more welcome back Sister Shalesia. She was sick on last week or the week before. So we thank God that she's here with us. But also Sister Whitney, Bentley Whitney. So look, we are now here going back. Not away abroad, but because of COVID, you know, she has to stay home and all of that. So thanks, Sister Whitney, nice having you. And those who are visiting with us, thank you for coming. Thank you for coming. Thank you. Please remember Bible study is online still, and so please tune in and grow. And there's a possibility that this will be the last of Who Am I? Series coming up Wednesday, all right? And so, please, let us tune in. Bible reading for this week, Hebrews 6 through 10. Chapter 6 through 10. Please, remember that, all right? Remember Sister Kelsteda Johnson, she was 91, by the way, 91, and she died yesterday. And truly, we want to be in prayer for the family. Sister Claudette, you remember. Sister Claudette is her daughter. Sister Carmen is her daughter. And you know, she has a few more children. We need two more. And so let us remember them, especially Sister Claudette, because remember, a few months ago, she lost her daughter, Shanice. So let us remember them in prayer, please. As they mourn, and also as we mourn, because Sister Johnson has been a long-standing member of this congregation. All right, so continue to pray for them. Sister Fancy Smith, Brother Bonnie's wife, you know. And so let us continue to pray for her, and also the Lance family, Sister Lance's family. Just remember them also. Okay? Also, Micaiah has lost his grandmother, and let us be in prayer for him and for that family also. Let us continue to be in prayer for the sick, you know, those who are not feeling well. Sister Jillie, as she recovers, as well as Sister Deborah Parton, as she recovers from illness also. Please. Nika Jessie Boudram, all right, my daughter. She's still in the hospital. Okay, they have done the surgery. They haven't done it? Okay, so she's still in the hospital. I thought they would have done it by now. So let's continue to pray for her. All right? Please. Please remember to put your offering in the box there. Please remember it's there for that purpose. And let us continue to observe the protocol. Okay? Protocols, remember, wear your mask, sanitize. Do your best, because many of our elderly are dying because of the wanton recklessness of our youth. Oh, we're free, it not affect us, but it's affecting the elderly. Affecting your mother, affecting your father, your grand, us. Please, yes, remember, youth fellowship on Friday at 5 p.m. Young people, please, try and make it out. Try and make it out, come enjoy yourself before the 8 o'clock curfew time. All happy. Please. Anything else that we need to? Oh, all congratulations to all of those who have passed and those who continue to be well in our congregation, please. Thank you for being well, and we continue to look forward to future aspirations and goals as you focus on a career path or you seek for college otherwise. All right? So congratulations again for doing well. For doing well. Let us all be standing at this time. Thank you all for coming once more. And God bless you as we continue through the week. Call somebody. Please call a member. Encourage a person. Encourage a person. We need that among ourselves. We need that among ourselves.
Right.
Praise God from whom.